Harper Audio presents Wedgie and Gizmo by Suzanne Selfors, performed by Johnny Heller and Maxwell Glick.
Chapter 1. Gizmo.
Greetings to you, dear reader. My name is Gizmo. As you probably heard, I am a genius. However, I am not a regular sort of genius, the kind who solves math problems or wins spelling bees. I am an evil genius, with an evil plan. Oh yes, it's true, a dastardly evil plan. But for now, my evil plan must wait, because I find myself in a most unpleasant situation. No, I am not wedged in a drain. That happened once. One of my beloved marshmallows fell into the bathtub, and I needed to get it. There is plenty of room in the pipe for my front half, but my back half is much rounder. Fortunately, my servant Elliot freed me, but alas, the marshmallow was never seen again. No, I am not cornered by a hungry feline, or as you might say, a cat. That also happened once. The cat crept in through a window and woke me from my mid-afternoon nap. Elliot was at school, so I had to save myself. I bonked the cat on the head with a toilet paper tube, then bit its nose. It never bothered me again. So, though I am pleased to report that I am not stuck in a drain and not facing a hungry cat, what I face at this very moment is worse. Much worse. I was forced to move to a new home, and it's pink. How did this happen? I shall tell you, but be warned, it is not a nice story. Yesterday, whilst enjoying an afternoon breakfast snack of carrot sticks, I was plucked from my echo habitat. Despite my squeals of protest, I was placed in a shoebox. After a lengthy journey, with neither a crumb to eat nor stick to chew, I awoke to find myself in a strange place. No one asked my opinion about moving. No one gave me time to pack, and thus all my hard work has been left behind. My tunnels, my treasures, my secret stash of marshmallows. I am irked, I tell you. Flustered. One day, when my evil plan is finished, all humans will feel my wrath. But until that day, you may send your letters and care packages to my new address. Gizmo, the evil genius, the Barbie playhouse atop the bookcase in Jasmine's room, nowhere near the Andes Mountains. Even though I have only been inside this horrid pink house for a few hours, I have gathered the following intelligence. One, Barbie moved out of the playhouse and went to a land called Goodwill. Two, though she left many pairs of plastic shoes, she will not be returning. Three, I am alone in this fiendish fortress. Barbie's decision to move is understandable. There is no nest in the playhouse, no cave or laboratory. The plastic oven and plastic refrigerator do not work, and the plastic toilet does not flush. The only place for the elimination of waste is a container on the top floor. Jasmine.
Gross, Gizmo pooped in Barbie's bathtub.
Elliot.
That's because you forgot to give him a litter box.
Jasmine.
I'm so glad I get to take care of him.
Elliot. You only get to take care of him because his cage broke during the move, and because Dad said I'm supposed to be nice to you.
Jasmine. You have to be nice to me because I'm your new sister. Don't worry, he'll be safe in my room.
Elliot, it's only for a little while, just until we buy him a new cage. Remember, Gizmo belongs to me. Until 3 days ago, Elliot was a loyal servant. He provided clean, shredded newspaper, fresh water, and alfalfa pellets that were bland but contained a balanced ratio of vitamins to minerals. In addition, Elliot oiled my exercise wheel so it did not squeak and washed the windows in my echo habitat so I could enjoy the view. He gave me a pair of glasses so I could watch the nightly news from the comfort of my nest. Elliot never tried to squeeze me into a tutu.
Jasmine, doesn't he look cute?
Elliot, no, he doesn't look cute. He looks ridiculous. Stop doing that.
Jasmine, but you said I could take care of him.
Elliot, I never said you could put doll clothes on him. Besides, they're way too tight.
Jasmine, well, it's not my fault he's shaped like a potato.
Jackson, ha ha, he's a furry potato.
The new girl's name is Jasmine. I am not fond of her. I do not understand why she must pick me up and kiss me whenever she walks into the room.
It is most unpleasant. And why must she carry me around in her pocket and sing songs to me?
My time is valuable. I am an evil genius with important evil work to do.
Mom, sweetie, don't you think you should put the guinea pig down?
Jasmine, Gizmo likes being carried.
Mom, but he's grunting and biting your finger.
Jasmine, that means he loves me, and I love him so much. He's the sweetest guinea pig ever. I'm so happy Elliot's letting Gizmo stay in my room.
How many times must I tell these humans that the term guinea pig is incorrect? I am not from the pig family. I am a proud species of rodent belonging to the Caviidae family and the genus Cavia. My species comes from the Andes Mountains, not from Guinea, but the humans insist on referring to me as a pig. Do I have a snout? No. Do I wallow in mud? No. How long must I bear these insults? Once I unleash my evil plan, they will never call me a pig again. Which brings me to my updated list. My evil plan. 1. Escape the pink prison and build an evil genius lair. 2. Return Elliot to his rightful role as my servant. 3. Become the king of all cavies. Create a cavy uprising and take over the world. Alas, Jasmine is sticking me into her pocket again. Why must I suffer such humiliation?
Chapter 2. Wedgie.
What a great day! I love this day! I wish every day could be like this day. I got half a waffle and some toast crust and a cup of kibble. I drank all the water from my bowl. I licked the shower floor, and I ate a dead fly. Now I'm standing at the door. It's time to go on patrol. Hello, let's go, people. Let's go outside. Mom, Wedgie, stop barking. My name's Wedgie, but my full name's Super Wedgie. I got that name because one night a long time ago, Jasmine tied a red cape around my neck and took me to all the houses in the neighborhood. At each house, I got a pat on the head, and Jasmine got treats that she put in a bag. There were lots of scary people wearing masks, but I barked at all of them and kept Jasmine safe. And when we got back home, I chased all the mask-wearing people out of our yard. The cape gave me superpowers. Now I wear it all the time. It helps me protect Jasmine and the rest of my pack. There used to be 3 people in my pack. Mom and her 2 pups, Jasmine and Jackson. But my new dad and his pup, Elliot, moved in, so now there are 5 people in my pack. It's my job to guard them from enemies and invaders. It's also my job to herd them so they don't get lost. It's a big job, but someone's gotta do it. And I'm that someone. Me, Super Wedgie. What a great day. Let's go, people. Let's go outside.
Dad, Wedgie, stop scratching at the door.
Super Wedgie has superpowers. If I run in a circle again and again with my cape flapping, I create an energized force field that opens the door. 10 times usually does the trick.
Mom,
oh, for the love of Pete, will someone take the dog for a walk?
Jackson,
I'll take him.
Mom, you're too little to take him. Elliot, would you do it? Elliot,
do I have to?
Dad, this is your chance to get to know your new dog. Elliot,
but he's not my dog. He belongs to them.
Dad, He belongs to all of us. We're a family.
The force field is activated. The door opens. I stand on the porch, my nose sniffing the air, my cape proudly displayed for all to see. Super Wedgie reporting for duty. Elliot stands next to me. He smells like socks and syrup. I love socks and syrup. And even though Elliot is new to my pack, I love Elliot. He puts on the leash so I can take him for a walk. Elliot needs the leash so he won't get lost. I gotta tug real hard to get Elliot moving. Come on, boy, let's go mark our territory. Everyone in the neighborhood knows me. I'm real important around here. They all wave and talk to me as I pass by. Neighbor:
Hey, don't pee on my roses.
Different neighbor:
Hey, stop chasing my cat.
Different neighbor:
Hey, you better scoop that poop.
Elliot puts my poop in a bag and carries it around. He must like the smell of poop as much as I do. And because I'm a superhero, my poop smells super poopy. I love Elliot. I lead Elliot around the block. I stop to smell squirrel tree. I stop to smell raccoon trail. I stop to smell duck pond. I know all this.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.